In this video, I'm gonna show you what I feel like is by far the best group dungeon healer build. So if you wanna get into group dungeons and maybe you have a hard time getting in, maybe some people are not inviting you because you have a weird healer build, brother, this video is gonna solve that problem for you. I'm gonna show you the best group dungeon healer build. In my opinion, at least. This is the build I use. And not only that, I'm gonna show you the build and show you how everything flows together and stuff like that, the things that I usually do, but I'm also gonna bring it in a practical real-life situation in a proper group dungeon that I did with some of my buddies. So you will be able to see exactly how everything flows together. Let me start by showing you the build already, man. Alright, this is the build that you wanna be using. It goes like this. Graveguard Helmet, Royal Robe, Knight Boots, Fallen Staff, Limhurst Cape, 4 Commals, the higher the better, but you definitely don't need to go this overboard. I just have this for other dungeons, and invisibility pods. Actually, you might want to be taking energy pods, but so far, even when I'm taking them, I'm almost never using them. But it's good to have some on you, and this is an important part. You also want to have some poisons on you. Those are not for you. Those are for the tank and for the rest of the team in case they run out of poisons. Yes, it's your job as well to have poisons on you. As a group healer, you might fall into a bunch of traps. One of those traps is the fact that each one of your spells heals by a lot, except this one and this one. So whenever you wanna heal a tank, let's say, you might be tempted, let's say the tank is at 75%, you might be tempted to just put an E on him. That will 100% heal him to full. But was it required? Did you really have to use that E? Couldn't you have used the Q, for example? This is the biggest trap a dungeon healer falls into. You are very tempted to just use your strongest spells. Because you just have so many of them, why not use them all? Am I right? Well, wrong. You do not wanna use them all. You wanna count your spells. You wanna make sure you know what you have. There's a bunch of rotations that you need to keep in mind. For example, sometimes you might just wanna poke Qs, just over and over again. But check this out, I'll show it on myself. If you poke too many Qs, like if you just heal over and over and over again somebody, something is gonna happen. And that thing is called healing sickness. What healing sickness does, and I'll show you in a second because I'm bound to get it, look at it. Caused by consecutive self-healing. Healing received is reduced by 40% and it stays for 50 seconds and every single time you heal that target, the cooldown resets. If this happens to the tank, he's probably gonna die. So you do not wanna spam your spells. I know, you might be tempted to just spam your Qs just so you make sure. Yes, the guy is at full health, you see that. But you wanna make sure that he is not about to die. Brother, you have to trust your healing potential. And to be able to trust that healing potential, you have to know exactly what you can do. There's two main ways in which you can get your tank to be full health. From zero to full health. My favorite way is by doing F and D. What the F does is that it creates a shield. So whatever you heal the tank with, it's gonna be shielded. This just shields your ally, as you can see. And yourself. So this is a very good skill that you can use even to get yourself out of a tough situation, because with this build, truth be told, you don't have a lot of mobility. And what the D does, which by the way you want to use right after using your F, it heals your opponent by a percentage. This is very important whenever you're playing with a tank that's using Guardian Boots, as I did today and as I will show you later on today. Because even if he's using Giant Boots and if he just used them and his health is doubled, he will still heal for 25%. The rotation would be F and D. And as you can see, the D heals for plenty, plenty. This can get anybody to full health. And if you need to, usually what I do, I F, D, and maybe Q. But sometimes, most times, I just have to get myself away because whenever I'm using my F towards the tank, I'm usually in range of a lot of abilities and I just have to get myself out of it. The second way you can get somebody to full health is by using your W. And what this does, check it out. I want you to look at the numbers on Leandre. Look at it. 140, 200 something, 400 something, 500 something, 700 something, 800 something, and 900 something. Almost 1,000 right there. If you notice, the healing ramps up. I'll show it to you again. Look at it. It just ramps up. So what you should do with this is try to... Like, this is not a save from a clutch situation. If the tank is like at 100 HP, this is not the healing you want to use on him. You want to use a Q and maybe then a W. You know the rotation of the mobs, let's say, and you know that the tank is about to take a huge amount of damage. Well, precast this. Just keep it on him. But again, wait for him to get aggro. That is very important. and as everything else, combine it with F if you have your F. But more often, if you have it, you should use the first combo, that is F and D. That's by far my favorite one. Now, as I said before, the reason you want to carry poisons is for the group, but that's not the only thing you want to do for the group. Of course, you want to heal the group, you want to keep everybody alive, and that's how you use your E, but I'll get to that in a second. But you also want to make your team stronger. And that's where the jacket comes in. Read this out. Place a magic rune with a 5-meter radius under your feet, lasting 6 seconds. What the rune does is that it increases magical damage and healing cast by 5%, and reduces cast times by 10% for up to 6 allies for every 1 second they stand in the rune. So the way you would use this, of course, you will buff yourself with it, but you don't, like, let's say that's my ally. I won't activate it here. If I have the chance, I will just get to my allies and drop it on them, and also stay inside of the rune myself, because this will also help me. Keep in mind that in the optimal group dungeon party, you will have more magic runes. You won't be the only one, so try to time it with them. Don't stack 2 or 3 of them at the same time. Try to time it. Wait for like the blazing to drop his, then wait for the perma, I think, uses it to drop his, then drop yours. Or however you guys decide to do it, but make sure to talk about it so you can synchronize with each other and keep a damage buff at all times. The only spell we didn't discuss yet is your E. The way you want to use your E is, there's 2 ways, mainly. There's the preventive way and there's the saving way. The E does a lot of healing, like just look at this. Look at this. That's a lot. Everybody except the tank will get topped off by that heal. So just trust it. As a general rule of thumb, if you're using your E as a save spell, as I like to call it, whenever 2 or more of your allies go to 50% health or 75% health and going down slowly, you want to cast your E. Because as you can see, it has a small pre-cast time and then it loads on the ground. You want to have this ready, you know? The other way of using your E is preventive. So let's say you are in one of those skeleton dungeons. And in those skeleton dungeons, there is that weird ghost somewhere near the end that will spawn 2 blizzards that will just spin like crazy. Well, you know people are gonna take a lot of damage. And at the same time, you wanna direct them towards the area they wanna be staying at, which is usually in the middle of those AoEs because they will spread apart. So with that knowledge, to direct them, you just put your E where they need to go. And everybody will just go there. And if they get damaged on the way, do not worry about it, because they just got healed. It's all good for everybody. But enough of me talking about all of this. Let me actually show you exactly how this build goes in practice. All right, let me show you everything you need to know when it comes to healing in a group dungeon. The first thing that I want to teach you is patience. Now, you see, I didn't heal him up until that moment because I would have got an aggro. And getting aggro, for me, that means certain death. So you don't want that, because if you die, the whole team dies. What you want to be doing is try to wait for the tank to fully get aggro. Whenever you see that he got aggro with his Q, with whatever, you can full DPS. As a general rule of thumb, anything that's not an auto attack will get aggro. And again, whenever 2 or more group members are damaged, either heal them separately if you can, or just, much easier, drop a group reset. The only place in which you kind of have to hold on to your group reset is whenever you're fighting against the boss. Because bosses work a little bit differently. Again, trust your W will tick by a lot and he will heal the tank, it will heal the tank by full. And another spell that I want to show you how to use is the R. The way you want to use the R, what the R does, it boosts your magic damage, your healing cast, and it just makes you a little bit stronger. You don't want to use it only for yourself, you want to use it for your team. So don't go like on the edge and use your R. No, no, stay on top of your team and use your R. What that's going to do, it's going to allow them to do more damage in the end. Check this out. See, like, somebody already used their R, so there's no use for you to use it as well. You don't need to use it as well, they already used it. But see, now there's none, so just use yourself. See, it's those moments in which you want to be able to multitask. You want to be able to focus everybody. Right now you don't have your E, so you cannot really do much about saving more people at the same time, so you want to be able to heal everybody, including yourself. That's also very, very important.